Today I'm just going to put this video together about this unique and super precise way of getting your sway bars bang on each side. And all we need, three items. We need scales, preferably the ones that you weigh your diff oil with, something that can weigh down to the sort of double digits of a gram, just if you want to get super accurate. Otherwise, other scales will do, but just not ones that you weigh your car with. So something that will weigh small amounts. We want two suspension pins, and you want your ride height gauge. Actually four items, setup board, nice flat setup board. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna get the most accurate reading from your sway bar, starting with a couple of simple points. What we're gonna do to start with, we've gotta make sure that the sway bars themselves are flat. So before you do this, you wanna put the sway bar on the setup board and just check that it sits flat. And if it doesn't, get that as flat as possible to start with. We want the best starting point that you can get. Get that as flat as possible. Install that into your car, and then also make sure that the arms and the suspension pins aren't bent and the arms are moving freely, and take off any top arms. So we're just, all we're dealing with here, bottom arms and sway bar points. That's it. What we're gonna do now, nice easy way to measure your sway bar tweak or balance each side, using these scales, I'm gonna show you what to do. Put these two handy suspension pins in the outer holes. Like so. We'll go this side. It's got the camera set up here, so it's a little bit awkward for me to do all this. What we'll do is we'll turn those on. They'll scale to zero. We will lift the suspension arm up with the car flat on the setup board and just drop that on there. We will re-tear that weight and get it to sit as close to zero as possible. Now on this side, we want to press down, not worrying about your droop screws, because we're not going to hit the droop screws. So we're going to get a super accurate reading by simply pressing this suspension arm down on this side, down onto the ride height gauge. So this part of the suspension arm, or any part, just as long as it's the same on both sides, so the reading's the same. So I'm going to say this side, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to press this down to 6 mil. And now you'll see the reading is 15.8 grams, which is the pressure through the sway bar pressing down onto the scales over here. Now, if we swap that, and do that on this side, 6 mil, press it down onto the 6 mil part, we've got 15.3. So now we've got both sides pretty close, and we're happy with that. I'm going to show you what half a turn changing each of the sway bar adjustments here, what half a turn either side does to this, and how many people run their cars off-road and on-road with that slight adjustment out. And how much of a difference it makes on the scales in terms of pressure, and how much load that sway bar is actually doing on the track, how much work it's actually doing. So here we go. So we've got even sides. I'm just going to take the scale off for now. I'm going to do half a turn in clockwise on this side, and half a turn out anti-clockwise that side. Now, if I pop that back up, re-tear that, try and get that as close to zero, and let's try that again. the side is now 10 grams. Pop this down. There we go. Press this side down. That side's now 21. So we've gone from with just a half a turn each side, which is, it's not a huge change. We've completely changed the sway bar. And a lot of the times, people don't realize it, and that's quite hard for them to work out how to do the sway bar tweak and get it accurate. This way tells you on the scales just what's going on, and that's all that matters, how much pressure is being applied evenly to each side of the sway bars. And this theory can be used on any car, off-road, on-road, front and rear. Try it and see what you think. It's super accurate. It takes away the back and forth of checking of droop blocks and all the different techniques out there. Just use the scales you've got and have it play, because it is awesome. You get it within 1 gram either side, and that's way better than what most people have got out there at the moment. And it does make a difference. Hope you enjoy.